Well, hello there, all you wonderful peeps out there in the interwebs. This is saying a hello from Tashlan and from Charlie the dog and Puddon Anpye the pussycats, who are outside somewhere enjoying this beautiful sunny weather. We are in Creativerse. I'm trying to get my bearings. I believe... Well, no, I know. We found turnips the last time. So our exploration was... Oh, that's pretty. Autumn leafy. Oh, I just heard Jingle Cat come in. I've ordered a couple of collars for the kittens, and only one has arrived. So I have one silent and stealthy cat and one Jingle Cat. they've both come in, apparently. Obviously, talking about them, I've summoned them, so they're here. I hope that they haven't stolen anything else from the neighbourhood children, which seems to be that's their new hunting technique. I mean, you know, it's nice to be able to teach cats to fetch, but why they would fetch children's socks, I haven't quite understood why. I think we need to set some goals. I know we've set up a teleporter, and brain work, and we found the turnip, so I'd kind of like to go back and do that. But also, if we're looking at our crafting, we've got cooking station to unlock. That's nice, because that means we can start making some food for ourselves, and all we need is obsidian, which is good. We're unlocking the iron mining cell. Now, this is also good, but we do have to go deeper because we haven't discovered any iron yet. So we don't have anything here. Oh, I'm so sorry about that noise. This is what happens when you live in a big city. Even though I'm right on the outskirts of a big city. So far that when I'm walking the dog, I actually leave the city, go round a corner, and then come back into the city. That's how far out of the city I am. But it's still noisy. Yep, look, we've got loads to unlock here. We've got the iron sword. So that means we need to get some feral pigsy fur. Iron leggings we've got, lots of feral pigsy fur I'm seeing, the iron pauldron, the iron breastplate, I need a breastplate then, that would be the top of someone's head, wouldn't it, and iron arm guards. Oh, animals, do you have to come in and make a noise? You were so peaceful 5 minutes ago, honestly. What else, do we have any other unlocks? I love this. Another new addition is that the TNT actually now looks sort of more dynamite-y. Before it looked like a big round blob. I really like the new sort of graphics updates they've done with that. And I think what we're also going to do is I'm going to teleport us back. I want to do a place where there's two buildings that I'd like us to work on. One would be like a teleporter area. I won't say like a tower or anything like that, but an area where we can put our teleporters so that we can label them and have it organized in such a way that, because I mean, this first base doesn't have to always be home base. We can pull this up and put a teleporter to here. This was our starting point, so it doesn't have to be our ending point. Not at all. But see, at the moment we've got our teleporter just shoved out here. So that's what I think we need to do. I need to see if I've got any seeds. I've got some stuff on me. So let's grind that into la 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 think tash. Okay, we've got that. Oh, we've ground something into seeds. Let's get our turnip. So, because once you've got one of something, then you can grow it. And that's the nice thing with the food. And also, I wanted to do the cooking station, didn't I? So, what did we need for that? We needed obsidian. And I honestly think we've got some in here. Yeah, we do. Nice. So, I think we can now craft ourselves a cooking station. Lovely, we can. Let us plop that down there so that we can throw it in there. Now, with a cooking station, as you can see, there are certain recipes. If you click on this, then it tells you what you need. You need a liquid and you need grain. And we don't have any of that at the moment. And then there's soup. And for soup, you need liquid, a vegetable, and an ingredient. Now, an ingredient can be a mushroom. I think if I, yeah, throw that in there, it can be that. It can also be another vegetable. And what you put in there does deter... Hello? There's a sheep in my bed. Excuse me, I'm not Welsh. Go away. Oh, dear. Such an intrusion. Right, so let's have that. I know we did have some liquid. I can't remember. Oh, the turnip seed discovered. Great. Okay. Did I put... I know I had water somewhere. I can't remember where I put it. I must have had water because I've got plants. Yes, there we go. There's various different liquids that you can get. You can get... Oh, I love the sheep's back. The Rambo. You can have molasses. And if you make bread with molasses, you get gingerbread. Mmm, so nice. You can get corrupted bread if you use corrupted water. You get... I can't remember what it is, but it's a healthy form of bread if you use mineral water. So depending what type of, you know, those base ingredients you throw into your cooker, it depends what you get out of it. Oh, look at all these cactus flowers. Our spawners are working. I love it when a plan comes together. Da, 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 da. See, farming for the win. I would like us to sort of get pets and that sort of thing. But where we are, it's a little bit mountainous. So, I mean, it's been great as a first base, but I think we really do need to find somewhere flatter so that we can establish a place to put pets and so on and so forth. Right, well, now we want to plant some seeds. So let me grab the seeds that I've got and throw them all down in my bar. And we will start harvesting and planting. Nice. We'll only harvest what we can plant, simply because this will go back into grass. And it's not a problem, but I'm too lazy to plough it out again. At least I'm honest. Okay, so now we've got some more stuff. We can go and we can... This initially is a bit... Well, it's a lot of a grind. A grind. I didn't mean to be so tacky with that. Once you start with more and more of the farming, I cannot use my words today. I don't know what is wrong with me. You will find... I was just trying to get some different type of... I cannot use my words today. It's the day after the Creative Crew have done their 12-hour live stream. I don't know yet what the absolute end result was as far as collecting funds. I do know we were doing very well. We were all having so much fun. Wow. It was great. We had loads of people joining in with us and playing along with us. It felt to me almost like a really good night out with a bunch of really good friends. So it was terrific. And looking forward to the next one. But I think I did so much talking and jabbering yesterday that I've just completely forgotten how to use words today. I'm going to have an awful lot of lettuce, aren't I? Okay. But we will start getting organized. I'm just planting for now. Okay. But lettuce is good for us, isn't it? Yeah, it's green and things and stuff. And we will chop all of that, and we will chop all of that. Initially, I tend to just chop because, words again, Tash. Because you need to build up a stock. I can do this. I can. I can use my words. So what I'll do is I'll definitely plant all the wheat seeds that I've got. And I think when we set this up, it was kind of so we'd have, 9 by 9 by 9 by 9. So we will have that eventually. But for now, we're having a lettuce bonanza, which is fine. And this should actually then give us enough seed. To actually store them in that chest over here. We'd probably be able to start doing a little bit more of an ordered plant the next time we do this. So that will be good. We'll let that chop. Okay. Now we did see that cave, didn't we? But we definitely do need to find somewhere where we're going to establish ourselves. It can be here, but I kind of think we need a better location. And before we start setting down too many teleporters and all this kind of thing, we need to find where we're going to want to settle. And I know that, I mean, Mulberry Villa, I chose to settle in Savannah. So I'd like to kind of avoid settling in a Savannah. Snow biome, we could do, but that, you do have problems keeping warm, which, let's face it, you do in real life. You go somewhere cold, you have to be concerned about keeping warm. So that is something we need to think about. Jungle, you're talking about sort of like a canopy dwelling more than anything then. And I'm not sure if that's really where we want to go. Yes, you see, we're going to have plenty of seeds to do. That was a thing. Didn't we plant a tree? I'm sure we planted a tree, didn't we? But where did I plant? There it is! Look! It's our tree! We planted a tree. It's our little tree. And what you can do... did we get any queen bees? Ah, I thought we had. Oh, we can throw that in there. Unless it's in one of the other chests... That's a possibility. Let's go see if we have a queen bee. We do. We only need one. So I'll collect both. because, you know, I'm an idiot like that. There we go. I can do it. I can do it. And I believe if we plant, I don't know, can we plant it in here? No. Can we plant it here? Yes. And there you see, it's coming up with the sprout not fertilized. So this means that it will actually grow. It will turn into a hive, I suppose we could call it. But yes, so it will do that. I'm very good with words today. I did all my talking yesterday. No more talking possible. I just locked myself in my house. Yeah. So, location scouting, I think, is the thing. I'm just throwing these seeds down there. I've got plenty of those seeds now. It'll only be, obviously, we won't have turnips because we've only managed to plant two turnips. But all the rest we'll now be able to stick to our grid. So that's nice. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to teleport to our last area of exploration. So we'll zoom. Zwing. we'll have a look at the map and see if we can't find where we would like. Because the main thing I find with Creativerse is creating nice areas of fast transit like this, and also storage. You definitely need storage. Okay, I gathered the block, but I didn't gather the block. Hey, look at this. Glitched them. Oh, now it's there. Okay. Okay, that's interesting. So this is in jungle. Obviously. Oh, I've got another queen bee. That's nice. That makes up for the one we've just planted. So you can see how there are quite a few resources here that are renewable. Wildwood isn't one of those renewable resources. You take down all the wildwood that there is and that's it, it's gone. Okay, so now let's look at the map. The mappity mappity map. Let's make it bigger, see where we are. Okay, so I think that we need to sort of head north and have a scout out and see what we can find there. I almost think it would be kind of nice to build something in a tundra area. So it's not going to be the freezing cold of the actual snow and ice, but we can get to build some, you know, almost like some sort of Nordic type build, which I think would probably be quite interesting. I know that there is a blueprint, and well, I do because I've built it, for a sort of Viking style longhouse. But I'm not sure if we're going to be building blueprints here. I would kind of prefer, I don't know, to do things that are original. Nothing wrong with blueprints. I am a big fan of the blueprints. They've been a big help to me in learning because, you know, you kind of learn, oh, look, you can place this type of block over there. I didn't think of that. But I think you do reach a certain point where you then want to express your own creativity. And this is sort of where I'm at in as far as building. Oh, we've got some canyons over here. See, this could be another possibility, is building. I've got to be careful because these are all creatures that could potentially give me quite a nasty wallop. I'm not in the mood for being walloped, either nicely or nastily. I don't want a wallop. I'm a good girl. Okay. Whoops. Lag gliding for the win. It's kind of fun. This kind of random. Random flying. Yes, I almost feel like, in a way, I've set my heart on a tundra build. We shall build in the tundra. And goodness knows where that very phony accents come from. Kind of makes me, puts me in mind of, excuse my voice, was one of the Goon Show, where they were all doing all these phony accents, and they clearly acknowledged that these were very cliched and over the top accents, and it was kind of, excuse me, second phony accent would like to say. And it was that kind of, and it's so funny. I don't know if anybody's ever heard the Goons, you know, Peter Sellers and Harry Secombe and Spike Milligan, but that went horribly wrong for me. I hit a wall. This is what happens when you fly without due care and attention, people. You die. So, yes. Okay. Epic fail. Scouting location 101. Don't fly into a wall. Okay, night pigsies. Don't. I'm gonna zwing. Zwing. So now we have a death statue to find. We've just been given our own little side quest of our side quest of a side quest. Oh no, that's not right. Okay. So, death statue is over there. Let's fly. We're flying at night, so we can't see where we're going. I should have slept thinking about it. Because the torch doesn't work when you're gliding. So we're flying blind. That's probably, in all fairness, why we actually flew into a wall in the first place. Yeah. Fly with your eyes closed. It's gonna happen. Oh. Alright. So, we've finished our search for the turnip. So now we're searching for location of our next base. I've kind of decided that we're gonna do tundra. I think it'll be nice. Whether I'm gonna do teleportation and storage in the same place, I sort of think that's probably a good idea. Simply because, oh dear, how are we gonna get up here? Okay, we're probably gonna have to dig our way up a little bit. That's fine, because this stone will come in handy. Okay, up here. It'll be a different sort of build for me, with a different kind of theme, which will be interesting. And tundra's usually reasonably flat, so I don't know. I think where I'm sort of going in my mind at the moment, where I'm not taking you with, because I really don't think that you want to be on a journey inside my mind. That's braver souls than me have done that. So I think what would be nice, if we had sort of an upstairs level that was all kind of open, and maybe sort of, oh, there we go, I can see our little beacon to our death statue. Almost garishly modern in a way is what I'm sort of thinking. Ooh. Ooh. There's a bit of a crevasse there. Okay. This is a bit scary. And have that with the teleporters. And I'm trying to get my way safely down here. Without dying. Preferably. What am I doing here? Oh, this will be why I died. Okay. Ouch. Okay. And then sort of an underground place for storage. Because I think I was saying this and then I lost words and just totally beflubbed everything. And that's valid. Those are words in some language somewhere on some planet. Okay, that's just simple water. We're gonna have fun finding our way through here. Is my light on? Yes. My goodness. Imagine if it wasn't. All right, let's go for a swim. I think having storage and teleportation somewhere. It doesn't have to be where your living space is. And I think that's what we're looking now. We're scouting location for... Oh my goodness, this is annoying trying to get through here. Okay, so let's go up here. Let's go up here. Eventually we'll get to a top somewhere and then we can maybe fly our way out of here, I think. So yes, but I think we're going to do it with a kind of... See, I'm so scatty. I'm sorry. I'm really scatty today. We're going to do teleportation and storage area. I was trying to think, can we do a big combined base? But I don't think we're going to do that on this world. I think what's going to be really nice is if... Let me see if I can do this. Yeah, well done, Tashlan. Very clever there. I'm sorry, guys. This is not very good recording from me. I think it'll be nice on this world to not have a combination shelter, farm, you know, all in one kind of space. I think it'll be something different for us to... I mean, we've got first base, so that's our sort of starting point. But that's all it is. It's just a starting point. It's not a finish point. It's not where we need to end up in any way, shape, or form. So... I just think it'll be nice to have set areas for set functions. I could be completely way off base and it won't work or whatever else. But again, that's the spirit of exploration. That's what Creativerse to me is all about. Is, you know, finding out, yeah, does that work? Does it not work? What works best? What is interesting to me? What is fun? And that's why we have these sorts of games that we're given tools and then we're told, go play. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play. I'm going to have fun. And I'm taking you with me on this journey. This crashing, falling, tumbling adventure. And that's pretty much what we're doing. So now, this This is a nice canyon biome. I wonder if this shouldn't be where we set down a second teleporter. Because this is huge. Let's land here. And let's consult our map. You see, we seem to be on an edge here, don't we? It looks like there's water. Yes. I think that we're going to set down a canyon teleporter here. These are not permanent. We can change them around and all that sort of thing. But I think that we're going to do that. And I can hear a trog. I can't see him, but I can hear him. So this code, let's give it something canyony. Let's put canyon stone there and ruddy canyon stone to return it. So far it teleports to and from nothing. That's good. So now we teleport home, plant a second teleporter. Okay, we're back home. And our plants are doing the woozy 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 noise. As they're probably... Oh, look at them, little seedlings. So cute. Oh, I'm sorry, did I say so cute? And it wasn't about you, pussycat. It's not always all about you. I have to say, right, so canyon stone would now be in the reverse, and you can see it teleports to something, and there we go. Now this means that if we leap into this teleporter, we will be now at that canyon stone point. I think what I'm going to do is off camera, and I know I said I wasn't going to do a lot of off camera stuff, but all I'm going to do off camera is I'm going to see if I can find our tundra, so that next time when I'm filming we can actually start building our teleportation and storage area. So I'm not going to do any building or anything like that. All I'm going to be doing off camera is pretty much what we've done for this last half an hour, is travel. So I'm going to spare you watching me glide over endless blocks, just because I think it's going to be more entertaining for me and more entertaining for you, for us to start planning out a build. And it's going to be much larger than first base. And I am not going to name the next build. The next build is going to come from you guys. You are going to tell me what we're going to call it. Now, I've told you its purpose is going to be storage and teleportation. It's going to be in tundra. The theme at the moment is wide open. But you tell me what we're going to call our next base. So I want you all to think about that. And until next time, from Charlie the dog, Puddon Anpye the pussycats, and from me, you know we love you loads. Peace out, peeps. I'm not